Hi, first grade, and welcome to our reading lesson. Today, we are going to be reading our SuperDuper nonfiction magazine. Remember, in our Super Kids story, Zoo Clue, Edabetta wrote riddles that led the Super Kids to different animals in the zoo. In this issue of SuperDuper, we will read more riddles describing animals. This time, you will be the one who needs to figure out the animal riddles. So let's take a look at our cover. The title of our SuperDuper is Who's Who? The subtitle is Animal Riddles. Remember, Who's is a contraction or an abbreviation for the two words Who is, and Who's Who is a question we ask when we want to know who someone is in a group. What is the same about all the pictures on the cover of our magazine? They all show animals. Which animal is leaping out of the water? The whale. Which animal is climbing a blade of grass? That would be our snail. Which is the animal with black around its eyes and a striped tail? That would be the raccoon. And which is the animal, the wild animal that looks like a dog? That would be the wolf. So let's think about what an animal riddle is and how you solve one. An animal riddle gives clues about an animal, and you have to think about the clues carefully and what you already know about animals to figure out which animal the riddle is describing. If I ask you if the animal riddle had the clue, "I am furry," which animal on the front cover could the riddle be describing? So it could be the raccoon or the wolf. How do we know that? These two animals have fur. This one clue helps you get close to an answer, but you need more clues before you can figure out which animal the riddle is about. What do you see on this page? It's all black with some sentences in a circle. What do you think this page will be about? Why do you think that? I'm going to read this page to you. Go ahead and follow along with me. Test your animal smarts. Look at the animals, read the clues, and then decide which animal the clues are about. What do you think it means to test your animal smarts? Needs to see how smart you are or how much you know about animals. Are these sentences a riddle? No. They are directions that explain how to solve an animal riddle. What should a reader do first to solve an animal riddle? Well, the text says to look at the animals. What step is next? Read all the clues. What is the last step? Decide which animal the clues are about. Why do you think the author started the issue this way? Well, I think the author started this way to explain what the readers need to do to solve an animal riddle in case they haven't ever solved one before. What animal is shown in each circle? I wanted to point out a word before we started reading, and that word is mammal. Remember, in science, we learned that a mammal is an animal that has warm blood and hair or fur, and usually its babies are born, not hatched from eggs. people are mammals too. I'm going to read the labels first. Anteater, owl, whale, bat. I'm going to go ahead and read this riddle. Read along with me. Riddle one. Surprise! I'm a mammal with warm blood like you. I eat bugs by the hundreds. I'm quite furry too. With luck, you may see me rise up in the sky. I'm the world's only mammal that knows how to fly. Turn the page to find the answer. What is an animal doing as it rises up in the sky? It's flying up into the sky. What important things did you learn about the animal from the clues? Let's see. It's a mammal. It eats lots of bugs. It's furry, and it can fly. Which animal do you think this riddle is about, and why? What do we need to do to find the answer? Down here it says, turn the page to find the answer, so let's do that. What animal was the riddle about? It was about a bat, right? Why? Let's discuss why a bat fits the clues and the other animals don't. An anteater is furry and eats bugs, but it can't fly. A whale isn't furry and it can't fly. An owl can fly, but it isn't furry. Only the bat is furry and can fly. Before we read the riddle, I want to point out this word. It is echolocation. The word echolocation has the words echo and location in it, and it has to do with finding things using echoes, sounds that bounce off walls and other objects. Go ahead and read this page to yourself. Okay, if you're not quite done, go ahead and pause the video and finish. Where can you find bats during the day? So during the day, they're in caves or under roofs of buildings. So bats are night animals. They sleep upside down in groups during the day. At night, they get busy hunting for food. Do bats eat lots of bugs? Yes. How do you know that? Well, the text says one bat can eat 3,000 bugs. That's a lot. How do bats locate or find bugs? The bats squeak, and the squeaking sounds bounce off the bugs. When sounds bounce off something and come back to the bat, it helps the bat figure out the size and shape of the thing. Even if it can't see the bug, the bat knows it's a bug and where it is. Bats also use echolocation to help them fly in the dark. The echoes tell them what's ahead so they won't crash into things. Other animals, such as dolphins, porpoises, and some whales, use echolocation to find their way underwater. Would you like to see a bat flying at night? Why or why not? What animal is in each circle? So we've got a raccoon, a bobcat, a wolf, and a rat. I think this time I'm gonna see if we can listen to the words.
Riddle two. My tail is hairy, thick, and long. My jaws are very, very strong. I often hunt in a team called a pack. We think that mice are a yummy snack. Arf! I howl. Arf, arf! I bark. If I sense danger in the dark. Look at the animals in the circles. The yellow labels say raccoon, wolf, bobcat, rat. Turn the page to find the answer.
What does this animal do with its pack? It hunts for food. What does it like to eat? That's right, it likes to eat mice. What would an animal bark if it senses or feels danger is nearby? Why would it do that? Maybe to scare off whatever it senses or to let the pack know there is danger. So as I read, I use the clues, the pictures, and what I already know to decide which animal makes sense as the answer. I can tell from the picture that a bobcat's tail isn't long. So the riddle isn't about a bobcat. I know that rats don't eat mice, so it's not about a rat. It must be a raccoon or a wolf. Which of these animals do you think it is? Why? Did you guess a wolf? How do you know that that answer is right? This page shows the answer and it shows a pack of wolves. What do you think you'll learn about on this page? We're going to learn more about wolves, and we know that because the answer page about the bats told more about bats. So this page will probably tell more about wolves. Go ahead and read this page to yourself. Okay, if you're not done, go ahead and pause the video and finish up and then restart the video. How many wolves are normally or usually in a pack? Who helps raise or take care of the young wolf pups? So a pack is like a big family. It has parents who generally stay together for their whole lives. Their pups, and usually a few older wolves that may or may not be related to the parents. Besides mice, wolves also eat bigger prey, such as deer, moose, or elk. When wolves can find plenty of food, then their pack might become larger. Why do wolves sometimes toss bones or branches to one another? They like to play. In what ways are wolves like people? How are wolves like dogs? Take a look and let's see what animal is shown in each circle. We have an armadillo, a snail, a crab, and a sea turtle. What is the same about all of these animals? They all have hard shells. Let's look at the word, this word right here, that is predator. Predators are animals that kill and eat other animals. I'm going to read this page. You can go ahead and read along with me. So it says, riddle 3. On land, I don't hurry. I'm slow, but don't worry. My legs can go fast when I swim. And when predators pass, I just eat my seagrass since I've got my hard shell to be in. Turn the page to find the answer. Let's see, does this animal move fast or slow on land? On land, it moves slow. When can it move fast? Right, when it swims. A predator might try to eat this animal. Why does it just keep eating its seagrass when a predator passes or goes by it? It does that because it has a hard shell to protect itself. It looks like all of these animals could be slow when they walk on land, but which do you think can swim? How do you know? So the crab and sea turtle can swim. The picture shows them in the water. This is a tricky riddle. Can you figure out the answer? Which animal is the riddle about? It was about a sea turtle. What do you think this page will be about? More facts about sea turtles, right? So a couple words before we read. Let's look at the word flippers right here. Flippers are a turtle's arms and legs. And the other word I wanted to look at is gracefully right there. Gracefully means to move beautifully. Let's see if we can listen to this page.
Answer 3, sea turtle. Sea turtles have long flippers that help them swim fast and gracefully. They don't come on land much, but when it is time to nest, a sea turtle will swim a long distance and struggle up the beach to lay her eggs in the place where she was hatched herself. Turtles have strong jaws, but no teeth.
What more did you learn about sea turtles? Where does a sea turtle go when it's time to build a nest and lay eggs? She goes back to the place where she hatched herself. What other animal did we learn about that has strong jaws? That's right, the wolf. Did you like solving these animal riddles? Why or why not? Remember, when you give an opinion, you want to support that opinion with a reason. Were there animals in this issue that you'd like to know more about? Which ones? In what ways is the Super Kids Story Zoo Clue like this issue? They both had animal riddles in them, both told about bats. How are the stories different? Zoo Clue is a make-believe story. Who's Who is an informational nonfiction text. The animals shown in Zoo Clue all lived in a zoo. The animals shown in Who's Who were all living in the wild. Okay, think about the word text structure. Remember, authors of informational texts can put together or organize facts in different ways. Think about how the author of Who's Who taught you about different kinds of animals. She used riddles. Let's go back to the first page and look at how the author organized her text. So on the first page, the author began the issue with directions that explain how to solve an animal riddle. Then she gave you a riddle with some clues. The page shows pictures of four different animals with labels that name each animal. The heading tells the number of the riddle, The riddle gives clues about one of the animals shown. And at the bottom, there are directions that tell you the answer, or tell you the answer is on the next page. I'm going to read this riddle again to you. Surprise, I'm a mammal with warm blood like you. I eat bugs by the hundreds. I'm quite furry too. With luck, you may see me rise up in the sky. I'm the world's only mammal that knows how to fly. What else do you notice about this text? That's right, it rhymes. Then the next page, page number 3, the author gives you the answer. She shows you the answer number and then names the animal that the riddle is about. And then the page gives you more facts about that animal. It also shows a big picture of the animal. Are the other two riddles in the book set up like this? Yes, it is. So there are different ways to give facts about animals. Why do you think the author chose to tell facts about animals using riddles with rhyming words? Maybe because it's a fun way to teach others about animals. The clues make readers think hard about what they know about animals. Now, in other SuperDuper issues like Mimi, that one was a story. It told the story of a poodle that saved her family from a fire. And we've read other nonfiction books that just give facts about animals. I want you to think about which kind of informational text you like best. Do you like the animal riddles? Do you like a true story about an animal? Or facts that are just given about different kinds of animals? So, I want you to think about that. Think about which type of informational text you like the best. The riddles, or a true story, or just giving the facts, okay? And your assignment when you stop the video is to go tell a family member, your mom or your dad or a sibling, which type of text you liked best and why. Okay, so until next time, I want you to stay healthy, be kind, and keep learning.